Director General of Health Ashley Bloomfield with us. Good morning.
Good morning.
Given it's Wednesday, you behind the eight ball?
Well, we got notified about this by our Australian counterparts last night around 8 o'clock, and we got onto it straight away. So actually it was a call from the Chief Medical Officer in New South Wales directly to our Director of Public Health. So
Wasn't a criticism, I'm saying, because it's Wednesday and this happened on Friday and Saturday, you behind the eight ball there?
No, well, actually, the person didn't get the positive test result till 4 o'clock yesterday afternoon, and late yesterday afternoon, and that's when the Aussies notified us.
So, were they positive in Wellington?
Well, we're assuming that they were infectious in Wellington because the results of the test, which came back late yesterday, suggest that, and they became symptomatic on Monday, actually, as they were on their way back to Sydney on the flight. It's my understanding. So we're assuming that while in Wellington over the weekend, they arrived just after midnight, on early Saturday morning. We're assuming they were infectious. So we've been working last night and we'll follow up again this morning on locations of interest. We will make those available as they come to hand.
How many you got so far?
None, actually, except, of course, the flights, which are important. And those flight numbers have already been publicised and broadcast, and anyone on those flights. Of course, one of them was a return flight to Sydney, so those folk will be followed up by the Australian authorities. But as those locations of interest come to hand, what I would say is that the person did do the tourist thing while here in Wellington, yeah. And so we're expecting quite a number of places, and we will make those available.
When did you get the call yesterday?
Well, I got notified just before 8 o'clock, and we had had the calls through sort of between 7.30 and 8pm last night.
And no calls last night? No locations of interest already if you're a tourist in Wellington?
Yeah, so what we did do last night is we found out quickly from our Australian counterparts not long after that about four close contacts, and those people were contacted and are isolating. And then our team here, actually, the folk at Regional Public Health, were able to talk directly with the person in Australia last evening, and so we're expecting we'll have locations.
Well, why aren't they out already? You ask them, mate, what'd you do in Wellington? Where'd you go?
Yeah, so that's why we're expecting to have those out very quickly, at least from the first interviews.
But why aren't they out now? You talked to them last night.
Yeah, well, I didn't talk to them. The team at Regional Public Health would have been late last evening, so they'll be putting that information together. And, of course, we like to notify the places of interest that they are a place of interest, and we'll get that information out as early as we can this morning.
Delta?
Yeah, the key thing here is to... Look, we're assuming all that the pattern here fits with the person being infected in Sydney, then travelling here and returning. So we'll assume it's the Delta variant, and, of course, it doesn't matter what the variant is, the important thing is for people to act quickly. So as we put out those places of interest, we'll need people who were there to isolate and get a test.
As you sit here this morning, you're nervous or not?
Oh, look, I'm always nervous about making sure we respond really quickly and that people do the right thing. But what we have shown right through all our responses is that if we get onto it quickly, we can get around it quickly, and that's by far the best thing. So everyone needs to lean in here and do what's asked of them.
Appreciate your time.